Hello Leo, how are you doing today? Welcome into the reading. Thank you for clicking onto this video as well. Let's get started. We are going to be able to, at the end of this reading, to see if a situation between you and your person is going to either be a makeup or breakup vibe. So let's get started. Let's clear the space of any previous readings that I've done, any energies that have been around on the table. I call in your energy to come in and your spirit guides as well to come and guide the reading for us as we move forward. I'm going to do this in a very interesting way. I'm loving the way I worked out the system of doing this specific reading. I actually think I might do it more often. It's very in depth and it gives a very clear picture of what is going on. We're going to get out five cards that's going to indicate your kind of thoughts or behavior as you move forward, and then we're going to see, as your thoughts or your behavior happens, what is their counteracting thought or behavior towards you, and we'll get an overall idea of what is going to unfold, because we're not always on the same page, guys, you know. So let's get started. Let's get out those five cards for you. Let's get out one there. By the way, guys, if you do like the video, please hit the thumbs up button for me. It does help me. It's your way of saying thank you for these readings that we do. What else as well? If you do like the readings and you want to get some more, watch more by me, they do come out 2 to 3 times a week. So hit the subscribe button, even the notification bell, so that you know when they come out. If you want a personal reading with me, there is a link in the description box below. The link is an email address, and it's in all that writing under the video. When you click into all the description, it will be in there with details about personal readings as well. So first vibe. Sometimes I kind of pick up on this card as being as what currently is going on right now. An ending. This is a breakup already. So you've already separated from them. You've had a breakup with them. You may be wondering more like, is this a reconciliation or not? You know, the ending has already occurred. I feel like it's been for some of you, it could have been 3 months back. For others of you, it's very fresh, like 3 weeks. I'm just picking up on this three energy, 3, 3, 3. Could have been like literally the beginning of July kind of vibe. And with this vibe coming through, for others of you, it could have been about 3 months ago. So you might be wondering, will they ever come back in? What is going on with them? What will happen? Let's see their energy right now. Well, a lot is going on with them. They are extremely busy right now. They could also be heading in your direction. For some of you guys, you've had contact from them. That's why the Eight of Wands is there. That's what is bringing up the Eight of the Tower as well. It's like, okay, there's been this ending. Now here they are, they've contacted me. Now what do I do? Do I keep communicating with them? They're coming in very quickly, very fast. If you haven't had contact from them, there's two. They will see where this is going to go. Let me just get another card. I'll tell you now. Hermit energy. Okay, if you haven't had contact from them, I feel like they're very busy in their life. As I said when I first turned the card. And I don't feel like they are going to contact you right now. You could be missing them with the Hermit card being there. It's two kind of scenarios coming through. If you've received contact from them, you may not have answered them. With the Hermit card being there, you may not have answered the message. Or if you've answered the message, it's very short. It's not like you're communicating. You're not opening up your soul to them kind of vibe. So that's what I'm picking up on here. Let's see. Next steps coming up here. You're really not seeing the good vibes here. You just don't want anything that's unbalanced. You may be a little reluctant to kind of get back together with them. You may be going, I've seen so much unbalance in this relationship with the Six of Pentacles coming up there. I don't want to actually be put back in a situation where I'm giving so much and somebody else is not giving back to me. So let's see their actions going forward here. Four of Swords, somebody is going to reach out to you. Oh, they're going to reach out. This person is going to contact you. If they have already contacted you, and you're not sure about what to do, they keep on trying to reach out to you. And if you're here and you're wondering, what is this person doing? They haven't contacted me yet. They're in this hermit mode. Somebody, you're going to hear from them. You are. That's why you could be feeling this right now. You could be wondering, what's going on with them? Why am I thinking about them? Do you think they might come back in? So we are all psychic, guys. It's just that people like me who do tarot readings, we focus on developing that part of ourselves. And if anybody had to focus on developing it, they would be psychic too. It's like, for instance, if you're a musician, you're working on that and you're developing that to be stronger. So you on some kind of level are definitely feeling this person because they're thinking about you. They definitely do want to come back in here. So let's have a look and see. But I feel like you're going, I don't know. If this is unbalanced, then I don't know. There's your stability. So they're coming in here. I do feel it from both of you. They're kind of coming in going, let's get back together with the Queen of Pentacles. Let's bring the stability back. Let's make us feel safe with each other again. But at the same time, you are going, my stability is the most important thing to me. Because if you look at the Queen of Pentacles, she's like literally holding that pentacle like a little baby over there. And you know, if you have a baby, that's the most important thing to you. And you're going, this is my stability and feeling safe in a connection and feeling like protected and needed and looked after is what is the most important thing to me. And driving that thought is what has occurred to you between the two of you before. So you're kind of going, if it's not stable, then I can't do that kind of vibe. Let's have a look and see. King of Cups rocking up in your reading. Yeah, I feel like you guys are reconnecting here. I'm just going to tell you, reconnecting with them is going to bring up a lot of emotions for you. It's going to bring up a lot of emotions. Oh, they want to come in. They're coming in very strong. It's bringing up a lot of emotions. They literally talking about stuff like settling down. That is what you want to hear. Exactly what you want to hear, they're saying it. They're going, let's get married. Let's get back together. Let's become a couple again. Let's look to the future. Let's stay together this time. Let's not break up with each other. And when that happens, your old heart there, it just gets activated like the first time you met them. And this is usually what happens. You know, love never dies. It does, actually. Then it was never real. Can I tell you? Funny thing is, it was never real maybe for one of you. Then love can die. But if love is kind of like was real and it was there, it's very easy to ignite that. Because even if the flame turns off, it's like a coal that's burning. It can easily ignite again. Just blow it a little bit and boom, there it is. So let's see. And this person comes in saying all the right things. High Priestess energy. You trust in your intuition. Both of you are. For them, the High Priestess coming up here, I feel like they're going, I am going to trust my instincts that I'm doing the right thing to be with you. And on your side again, I feel it as being, I'm hoping that everything works out and this is the path that we're meant to be on. If they're coming back, then it must be meant to be kind of thing. By the way, I forgot to tell you, we've also got the Hermit here, which is Virgo's energy as well. So let's go and see next vibes coming through here. You're still not sure. Like I'm saying, you know, you like going, well, if they're here, then it must be meant to be. It's like you're trusting your intuition as well, but I feel like you're also not too sure how things are going to unfold with the two of materials being there. You're still seeing how things go. They just want a reconciliation with you. Death card coming in here. That is without a doubt somebody coming in and going, you know, that Scorpio's energy as well. I just want to have this rebirth of our connection, the reconnection of the two of us, and we can move forward. It's actually a very straightforward reading. I feel like you're carrying the doubts. You're carrying the dots. Like, I don't know. A nice card fell. It's a Six of Swords. Let me just pick it up quickly. Yep, you guys are definitely, as far as I can see from the cards here, really moving forward. Whatever caused the breakup, you're moving away from that energy. Moving into smoother waters. I gotta see what's coming here. Hierophant, you're learning some things here. That's a card of wisdom. Nice card to come out here. Honestly, when it's in the reverse position like this, I almost, as I turned it, it kind of reminded me of somebody who's not playing or somebody who is not taking nonsense, somebody who's serious. Because, you know, think of the Hierophant energy. It can be traditional as well. By the way, it can also indicate marriage. And that's why I'm saying it's like somebody is not playing. Yeah, you mention commitment to me, you better start showing it to me. I'm not playing with you. Because the thing is with the Hierophant energy, think of it like this. Hierophant energy indicates wisdom. So at what level of wisdom are you looking at this from? And with the Hierophant being in the upright position, so if it was the other way around like this, it would indicate that you're doing meditation and yoga, and you're going to focus on that because it's something you want to do. When it comes up in the reverse position like this, it's next level. So it's like you're not just doing meditation and yoga, you literally packing your stuff and you're going to go live in an ashram for the next year. You're going to go and become a Buddhist monk and you're going to do some real yoga and meditation. And I feel like this is you going, yeah, you're talking about something serious with me. We better be serious because I'm not playing. I'm serious. You see, you're taking it to the next level. Let's see their energy. King of Swords, Queen of Swords energy. That the way you react towards them, it makes them feel a bit defensive. I kind of feel like it's a little bit of a hot and cold energy. This kind of reaction towards them is like you're putting your foot down, because that's what Spirit Guide said, is like putting their foot down. I feel like you're going, yeah. You coming in here, I'm not playing with you. This is what I'm expecting. That's what you do, by the way, because that's when you'll see the truth. They do take it a bit of a blow to their ego, I feel, and a little bit of a hot and cold situation between the how they accept it, but it's like double-sided sword, because you look at the Queen of Swords energy, sorry guys, the Queen of Swords energy, it's double-sided, that sword. So one side's got a bit of a darker energy, one side's lighter. Usually indicates dark and light, or hot and cold kind of vibe, opposites. So they do listen to you, they do accept, and at the same time, there's a little element of them that's going, wow, wow, you know? So let's see, Two of Wands energy, there's going to be a bit of an ultimatum vibe coming through here from you, and I feel like that's what makes them go, wow, okay, then what now? You know, they're accepting it, and there's a part of them that's also not accepting it, but I feel like you're giving them an ultimatum with the Two of Wands being there, because the ultimatum, it's about a decision and a choice that needs to get made. It's almost like you're going, you see, I'm standing here, I've got this World card. And the world card, you're holding the world, okay? And it's two decisions that you need to make. And you're going, if you don't come with this energy towards me, I will move forward without you. I'm going to take this wand and I'm going to go out there. I'm going to move forward. I'm going to leave possibly you behind. So if you want to be with me, you have to take these actions now. I kind of feel like there's an ultimatum coming from you here. They do accept the ultimatum, and a part of them fears it, a part of them wants it, and a part of them doesn't want it either. But if you're going to ask me if you guys are going to make up or break up, I do feel like your makeup, it is going to move forward. Expect a bit of reluctance sometimes. It's like they're talking a lot here, but when it comes time for action, they can sometimes have that problem of not really taking that action. They can talk quickly, and then is the actions following? Because the Queen of Swords energy is literally a very logic energy. It's very logical. So when the Queen of Swords makes a plan or discusses something like the Three of Pentacles, the Queen of Swords would then take practical steps to reach this goal. And when it comes in the reverse position, it kind of indicates, yes, the words are there, the thoughts are there. But when the practical steps come in, it can be a little bit confusing or not really the right steps to be taken. So I kind of got the vibe, yes, you guys will go on, but expect a little bit of reluctance or holding back or indecision from them. And I guess that makes you, it is, you are going to move forward because they're there, but at the same time, I feel like there will be certain aspects of things that they do that makes you go, I will walk away if you don't change this. So there's a possibility they can move forward with you, but they drag their feet as they're going forward. There we go. Thank you so much for coming into this reading and listening. I'm wishing you all the best moving forward. I'm sending my love in your direction. Bye.